Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Assistant
As
Professor,
Ankun
Department
Class.
of History and
This
Arts,
is Mr. Draikpal,
Arts and Social Sciences.
Visiting Teacher of Department of History and Art
Center,
Division, University of Education, Bank Road Campus, Lahore. I'm here with the course of Foreign Policy of Pakistan, Program MA. Course code is HIST 4116. Today we are going to discuss the topic World War II. As you people know that this is a huge topic, that's why we divided it into two. So in the topic of World War II, we will discuss the date, location, belligerents, causes, events, results, losses and aftermaths. So this is a very huge topic because World War II started in 1939 and ended in 1945. So we divided it into two lectures. So first of all, we are going to discuss what is World War II. First, we have to know that what is World War II. World War II was the biggest and deadliest war in history, involving more than 30 countries, sparked by the 1939 Nazi invasions of Poland. The war dragged on for 6 bloody years until the Allies defeated Nazi Germany and Japan in 1945. Basically, it's Hitler's invasions of Poland in September 1939 drove Great Britain and France to declare war on Germany, and World War II had begun. World War II was the biggest and deadliest war in history, involving more than 30 countries, sparked by the 1939 Nazi invasion of Poland. Date: World War II lasted from 1st September 1939 to 2nd September 1945, 6 years and 1 day period of the whole war. Basically, this is the period of 6 year and 1 day. If we are going to discuss the location, it's a Europe, Pacific, Atlantic, Southeast Asia, Southeast Asia, China, Middle East, Mediterranean, North Africa, Horn of Africa, Australia, briefly North and South America. These are the locations of this deadliest war, and this is the war, and the war period is for 6 years and 1 day, from 1st September 1939 to 2nd September 1945. This is a huge or long period war, that's why this is called the deadliest war in the history of the world. Powers and leaders. If we're going to discuss the powers, Allied powers are Britain, United States, South Union and France. And the leaders: in Great Britain, Winston Churchill is a very famous leader during the World War II. Prime Minister of Great Britain during most of the World War II, Winston Churchill was a great leader. His country was the last country fighting against the Germans in Europe. He is known for his famous speeches to his people when the Germans were bombing them during the Battle of Britain. In United States, Franklin D. Roosevelt, one of the greatest presidents in the history of United States, President Roosevelt led the country out of the Great Depression and through World War II. In Russia, the great leader is Joseph Stalin. Title was General Secretary of the Communist Party. He led Russia through tribal and devastating battles with Germany Millions and millions of people died. After winning the war, he set up the Eastern Bloc of Soviet-led communist states. If we discuss the France, in France, the great leader is Charles de Gaulle. Charles de Gaulle, leader of Free French, de Gaulle led the French resistance movement against Germany. Axis, Germany, Italy and Japan. Leaders, in Axis, leaders were that time Germany, Adolf Hitler, the main figure and most prominent figure of the World War II is from Germany. His name is Adolf Hitler. Hitler became Chancellor of Germany in 1933 and Führer in 1934. He was a ruthless dictator who hated Jewish people. He wanted to purge Germany of all weak people. He also wanted to take control of all the Europe. In Italy, Benito Mussolini. Mussolini was supreme dictator of Italy. He founded the concept of fascist government, where there is one leader and one party that has total power. He was an inspiration of Adolf Hitler. The next one is Japan. In Japan, Emperor Hirohito. Hirohito reigned as Emperor of Japan from 1926 until 1939. He remained Emperor after the war. The first time his subjects heard his voice was when he announced Japan's surrender on the radio. Before it, his subjects even did not listen his voice. The first time his subjects heard his voice was when he announced Japan's surrender on the radio. This is actually, I mentioned that that his subjects heard his voice because this is show the connection of the subjects and the emperor. Between the subjects and the emperor, this is shows his their connections. So I hope you can understand the date, location and the leaders of Allied and Axis. Now we are going to discuss the causes of the World War II. There were a variety of factors leading up to the Second World War. The death and destruction of World War I was so horrible that it was called the war to end all wars. Yet the agreement to end World War I did not resolve the problems of the world, and according to some historian, lead directly to the next catastrophe, World War II. Basically, this war is called the World War I is so much deadly, that's why that World War I called the war to end all wars. But after few years, the world faced a more and more deadliest war and long period war in the history of the world. World War I is basically from the period of 1914 to 1918, but the World War II is from started from 1939 and ended in 1945. This is a huge period and this called the deadliest time period in the history of the world. So if we discuss the causes, first of all, the main cause of the World War II is Treaty of Versailles, which is done by after the World War I. The Treaty of Versailles ended World War I between German and the Allied powers. Because Germany had lost the war The treaty was very harsh against Germany. Germany was forced to accept the responsibility of the war. Damages suffered by the Allies. The treaty required that Germany pay a huge sum of money called reparation. The problem with the treaty is that it left the German economy in ruins. People were starving, a government was in chaos. Due to the Treaty of Versailles, Germany's economy is totally shattered. The next cause is economic depression. The whole world was hit by an economic depression in late 1920s. In a depression, economies shrink, trade is reduced, business closes, prices fall, banks fail, and unemployment rises. Sometime during a depression, people look for a strong political leader to resolve their problems. In 1933, Adolf Hitler became the leader of Germany by promising to restore German wealth and power. Germany's militarism. Hitler immediately began secretly building up Germany's army and weapons. Although Britain and France knew of Hitler's action, they thought a stronger Germany would stop the spread of communism from Russia. In 1936, Hitler ordered German troops to enter the German-speaking areas of the Rhineland, currently called France, Austria, and Czechoslovakia. At this point, neither France nor Britain was prepared to go to war. In 1936, Hitler made alliance with Italy and Japan. The military alliance of Germany, Italy and Japan was called the Axis Powers. Failure of the League of Nations. The League of Nations was an international organization set up in 1919 to keep world peace. It was intended that all countries would be members and that if there were disputes between countries, they would be settled by negotiate rather than by force. The League of Nations was a good idea but ultimately a failure. Not all countries joined the League, and the League had no army to prevent military aggression, such as Italy's invasion of Ethiopia in Africa or Japan's invasion of Manchuria in China. The next cause is, and the main cause is, Hitler and Nazi Party. In Germany, Adolf Hitler and the Nazi Party rose to power. The Germans were desperate for someone to turn around their economy and restore their national pride. Hitler offered them hope. In 1934, Hitler was proclaimed the Führer leader and became dictator of Germany. Hitler resented the restrictions put on Germany by the Treaty of Versailles. While talking about peace, Hitler began to rearm Germany. He allied Germany with Mussolini and Italy. Then Hitler looked to restore Germany to power by expanding his empire. His first took over Austria in 1938 when the League of Nations did nothing to stop him. Hitler became bolder and took over Czechoslovakia in 1939. I hope you can understand that these are the major causes, and the main and major cause is Hitler and Nazi Party from Germany, because in World War II, Germans faced the defeat. And the war ended on the Treaty of Versailles, so they faced the consequences of World War One. That's why they turned and came with new power. Failure of appeasement, agreeing to the demands of another nation in order to avoid conflict. During the 1930s, politicians in Britain and France began to believe that the Treaty of Versailles was unfair to Germany and Hitler's actions were understandable and justifiable. This belief, adopted by Britain by the policy of appeasement, in the agreement, Britain and France allowed Germany to annex areas in Czechoslovakia where German speakers live. Germany agreed not to invade the rest of Czechoslovakia or any other country. In 1939, Germany broke its promise and invaded the rest of Czechoslovakia. Neither Britain nor France was prepared to take military action. Then German troops invaded Poland. Britain and France immediately declared war on Germany. World War II had begun in Europe. This is the major cause of begin the war. Rise of fascism. First of all, what is fascism? Fascism called the type of government where a one party government and the dictator is holding the all charges, and the subjects has no freedom of speech, they have no freedom. So fascism was a movement that began before World War One, but did not become a serious political power until Benito Mussolini took control of the Italian government in 1922. Under Mussolini, Italy became a totalitarian government where labor union were abolished and political opponent were killed or silenced. This caused many things to happen to Italy's social and economic problems. The first of these problems was the lower living standard of the Italian people. The people lost their 8-hour work per day protection, and their wages were lowered by the government. Worldwide Great Depression. The period before World War II was the time of great economic suffering throughout the world, called the Great Depression. Many people were out of work and struggling to survive. This created unstable governments and worldwide turmoil that helped lead to World War II. Leading up to the war, January 30th, 1933, Adolf Hitler became Chancellor of Germany. His Nazi Party or the Third Reich take powers, and Hitler is essentially the dictator of Germany. 25th October 1936, Nazi Germany and Fascist Italy from the Rome-Berlin Axis Treaty. 25th November 1936, Nazi Germany and Imperial Japan signed the Anti-Communitarian Pact. This was a pact against communism and Russia. 7th July 1937, Japan invades China. 12th March 1938, Hitler annexes the country of Austria into Germany. This is also called the Anschluss. Thank you. I hope you can understand. This is our first lecture on the World War II. In the further thing we will discuss in the second lecture. I hope you can understand. If you have any problem, any query, you can call or you can text me to ask it. Thank you so much, students.